good?
When we go now?
Just the first paragraph.
Okay. I was being raped, but I had a smile on my face. I had to act
like I enjoyed it. In 2010, I received notification
that my pornography was found on the internet. I talked to my investigators,
to my officers and detectives, and found out that the
IP addresses were changing, and realized that even though I'm
physically free, my imaging was still being sold. When I let my mind go there,
I feel like I'm being raped and exploited still,
because they're still making money off of my pain,
my trauma,
and my humiliation.
Whenever someone says the word porn, it often elicits a gut reaction of embarrassment and uneasiness. It's a secret activity people do in the comfort of their own privacy, spending hours a week browsing countless porn sites and clicking through numerous videos. It's a place of relief for many, away from the hustle and obligations of school, work, and family, and a place of sexual experimentation. But because no one discusses their average porn intake like they do with, say, how many Netflix shows they watch, the massive size of the porn industry therefore goes largely unknown. So, I asked a few people how much they think the porn industry is valued at.
Can you take a guess of like how much the porn industry is worth in dollars?
1 billion.
5 billion.
500 million?
I'll go 20 billion.
800 million.
$30 billion.
50 billion.
$50 billion.
50 billion.
80 billion?
100 billion.
100 billion.
It's actually 97 billion.
Oh. That's a lot.
Oh, fuck.
Really?
Yeah.
97 billion.
Oh, wow.
I was halfway there.
Yeah. $97 billion. That's how much the porn industry is valued at. Porn sites get more traffic than Netflix, Amazon, and Twitter combined. All the porn watched in 2016 on one singular website was enough data to fill 194 million USB sticks, enough to wrap around the moon if put end to end. In 2019, Pornhub had 42 billion visits, which equates to 116,438,356 visits in one day. That's 49,218,356 more people than the current population of the UK. More than 5,824,699,200 hours of porn were watched on just one site in 2019. That's almost 66,500 years of content consumed in 1 year on just one site. A study done in 2008 across various university campuses found that 87% of young adult men ages 18 to 26 and 31% of young adult women use porn to some level. 93.2% of boys and 62.1% of girls have viewed porn before the age of 18. 90% of teens and 96% of young adults either actively encourage or passively accept porn when talking about it with their friends. Pornography is also a surprisingly widely referenced practice in Western media within TV shows and movies, therefore contributing to its wide acceptance and normalization amongst the public.
Cool. Whoa! Is this porn? Jesus Christ! Look at the organization here! Clockwise rim job, counterclockwise rim job!
I'm sorry I was a bad girl. Please don't give me detention.
They've got like thousands, literally millions of naked pictures on the internet.
Let me ask you this. What type of porn made you, you know, messy the computer chair?
This is Hustler, and this is a much more exotic magazine.
Now, what exactly are the implications of the porn industry being so popular, of it being such an integral everyday part of so many people's lives? Not only that, but so widely accepted and normalized. Surely, watching consenting adults in the privacy of your own home couldn't possibly have any negative effects on the world, right? Why do any of these stats even matter?
Pretty much every trafficking victim I've ever seen, pornography has been created of them.
Working with those who have been sex trafficked, we already knew that pornography was a part of the experience while they were being sex trafficked.
There isn't pornography over here, prostitution over here, and trafficking over there. They're interlinked.
There is an overwhelming pile of empirical evidence as well as personal anecdotes from survivors that proves an inexplicable link between pornography, human sex trafficking, and abuse and violence. Love 146, a human rights organization dedicated to ending child trafficking and exploitation, defines human trafficking as the practice of luring, coercing, or otherwise removing persons from their home or country and then forcing them to work for no or low payment or on highly exploitative terms. In order for something to be considered trafficking, it has to involve force, fraud, and coercion.
Pornography is really prostitution on screen. The traffickers are the same, the pimps are the same, the women and girls and men and boys are the same victims that are being sold in the sex trade.
When you're watching porn, you are very often likely watching someone else's sexual trauma on camera.
In many cases, the women that appear in pornographic films are not freely consenting actors. They're prostitutes, forced by their pimps to perform sexual acts on camera, essentially making double the profit for the pimps.
This is someone's daughter, you know, sister, maybe they're someone's mother, potentially being forced against their will, and you're sitting there jerking off to someone being raped.
One of the girls was like, I was on so many drugs just so I could numb the feeling of what was actually happening. So they're actresses, they're pretending to enjoy this, and like, they're literally, like, they're getting beaten and brutalized. 60% of the content on Pornhub is user generated, which means just you and I can just upload content videos. So we can be running, you know, sex rings and have, you know, girls just one after another coming through this. And yes, some of them may get taken down, but the amount of volume that's on Pornhub, like, it would take you like 160 something lifetimes watching continuously to be able to see all the porn that's on Pornhub.
Pornography doesn't even contribute to just human trafficking alone specifically, but it promotes sexual abuse and violence in general. Dr. John D. Fopert, who's written over 20 peer-reviewed articles on the harms of pornography, provides an alarmingly eye-opening analogy to demonstrate this concept.
There have been over 50 studies showing a direct link between pornography and sexual violence. And from statistical odds, here's what we know. You take the Empire State Building, you fill it with pennies, and then you take that and you make 1 billion Empire State Buildings filled with pennies. The odds that you pick the right Empire State Building out of 1 billion of them, you go to the right floor and you pick out that right penny. That one penny represents statistically the likelihood that really there's no connection between porn and sexual violence.
Dr. Fobert is not the only expert who has these same conclusions. Dr. Jill Manning, a licensed marriage and family therapist and certified clinical partner specialist, shares similar results.
In the last 10 years especially, we've seen an increase in the number of studies coming out showing a correlation and association between pornography use and domestic violence. And we know from a number of studies that if someone is a regular consumer of pornography, their risk for becoming abusive and aggressive increases by at least a third.
One of the things that they prey upon is being able to show, like, basically how much abuse one can take, how violent something can get.
So, some of you might be wondering, what exactly does this have to do with me? Surely I, a single person, cannot be contributing to sex trafficking and abuse and exploitation just by watching porn, can I? Think again.
It's so easy to think that when you're looking at porn, that you're in no way part of the problem, that you're just simply using the entertainment that is there for everybody.
I really wish that people who watch porn knew more about that, because I think they believe that they're engaging in this activity in a very passive way, and they're like, oh, I'm doing it in the privacy of my own home, and this is just a video that I'm watching.
Each and every viewer feeds demand. Each and every viewer is further victimization of that person whose degradation and sometimes out-and-out abuse and violence is being filmed.
And they're not associating it with the fact that pornography is very often the filmed rape of sex trafficking victims.
Each click, click, click is another level of violation.
These victims, they're victimized once when they're sexually abused, but they're victimized then over and over and over again as these images are recirculated on the internet.
So many survivors have shared their personal mortification and overwhelming fear of knowing that anyone at any time can watch their pornography online.
As survivors have explained to me, pornography is a document of a woman's humiliation, and it's out there forever, and it causes extreme emotional distress.
I think what makes the porn industry different than other forms of selling sex is the fact that everybody forever can watch some of the most horrible things I've experienced in life.
So it's safe to assume that some viewers watching this will simply conclude, well, I'll just stay away from the porn that looks like it's rape or trafficking, which may prompt you to ask, so how do I tell the difference between consensual porn and non-consensual porn? That's the thing, you can't.
You cannot guarantee that when you are looking at an image on the internet that someone is not being exploited in that. You cannot guarantee that.
I think people think that watching pornography is okay because they say, well, everybody has consented to it and they're all paid actors and they're consenting adults, so it's fine. But the reality is, and I've heard this from survivors, and what they really want all porn consumers to know is that when you are watching pornography, you actually have no way of knowing if you're watching somebody being raped or voluntarily engaging in that act.
There isn't absolutely zero hope, though. There are actually numerous ethical porn sites you are able to use instead that upload videos that focus on consent, integrity, transparency, diversity, and portraying actual realistic sex. It's usually not free, though, but please do not let that deter you from considering these sites, because it's actually a good sign, since that means that the actors and actresses are more likely getting compensated properly, and the money you pay is invested into the ethicality of the videos. Another important factor is to educate. Tell your friends, family, classmates, coworkers, and whoever else the harms of the pornography industry. Having open dialogues about difficult topics is always where change happens the most effectively.